I'm sorry about that before. I was upset, Robert.
Look, it's
all right. Dad's dying.
You don't have to explain.
Think she'll be all right?
I just have to trust the doctors. I don't know what I'll do if anything happens to her.
I know. She seems happier with you than she did with Dad. I suppose that's a bit hard to accept sometimes.
She's very proud of you, you know.
Yeah, well.
Look, there's another chair. Why don't you wait with me, and then when she wakes up, she can see the pair of us.
Yeah. Thanks, Levin.
I'm sorry to disturb you so early, Mrs. Reynolds, but I thought it more appropriate than a phone call.
It's quite all right, Inspector. The local police phoned.
So you know about May Collins?
Yes, I thought you had the situation under control.
Well, we did. It was just one of those unfortunate incidents. Well, what can you say?
How's Beecham?
Hasn't been hurt, being looked after. The department thought it best to go ahead with the pardon, so she won't have to come back to Wentworth. The minister will get the papers to you today. There'll be a press release explaining about the robbery and the arrest of the American. Of course, as we agreed, Willie's name won't be mentioned.
I see.
We're trying to get the whole situation cleaned up as quickly as possible.
All neatly packaged up and filed away under forgotten.
Well, hardly that, Mrs. Reynolds.
No. I've lost women before. Heroin addicts, prison riots, murders. No matter how many times it happens, you always feel shocked. Guilty in some way. Responsible.
So, where would you like to work?
You really gonna do it?
Well, of course. Who's gonna stop me?
Nora.
Rita might. Oh, she's only here on remand. They're not gonna back someone who's gonna be walking out of the joint in 5 minutes. Now, where would you like to work?
Repairs, I guess.
Right. Jacko, you're on the washing machine. Flynn the dryers. You and you're doing the folding. And Young, take the skip.
What's Lurch doing?
Repairs.
Oh, that'd be right. Nice cushy job, eh, Lurch? Get to rest your big fat bum all day, eh?
Shut your neck, Connors.
I say whatever, whenever I like. Get it?
Yeah, well, if you can work as well as you can talk, we should get a lot of work done today. Well, come on, what are you all standing around for? Get to it.
You getting sleep?
No.
Look, Carr, the minute I get the word, I'll take you downtown, get everything fixed up.
To collect my 30 pieces of silver.
Hey, come on, you earned that reward.
I did nothing, May did it all. Look what she got. We should never have trusted the police.
May knew the risks as well as you did. She thought it was all right.
No, she didn't. She didn't want to do it. We were talked into it.
Hey.
Tricked into it. By that inspector and Mrs. Reynolds.
If anybody's to blame, us at Yank. He'll get what's coming home.
Don't worry, Mr. Harley. Everyone responsible will get what's coming to them.
Good morning, Miss Wilder.
Good morning, Mr. Adams.
Eve, what's wrong?
She knew. Mrs. Berry knew I had to do it.
Mrs. Berry?
I did it for you. She was going to tell the governor your career would have been finished. Nobody suspects me. I had the perfect alibi, but You have to get rid of these.
Oh, no, no, no.
David, I did it for you, for us. You have to help me.
But what's the point if she comes out of the coma?
She can't. Think of our lives together when all this is over.
What do you mean?
Look, they don't expect her to come out of the coma anyway. And even if she does, she'll just be a vegetable. Don't I mean anything to you? We have our whole lives ahead of us. David, there is only one way out.
Yes, right. Thanks for letting us know, Mr. Pringle. Bye-bye. No change.
Better than bad news, I suppose. The waiting's the worst thing.
No, the worst thing is that Keane pulled the wool over our eyes, and now Joyce Barry's suffering. Mr. Adams, sign out if you don't mind.
How are you?
Oh, fine, thank you. Hope the wedding rehearsal goes well this afternoon.
Yeah, it's 3 o'clock, isn't it?
No, 12:30, I think.
Ah, yeah. I'll be there.
Ladies, you amaze me. You just haven't thought this through at all.
It was a no-win situation for us, anyway.
That's right. Alive on the inside or dead on the outside. Inspector Gordon's assured me that this man would follow you and keep as close to you as possible at all times.
That's right. Any sign of trouble, he'll be there. He'll get you out.
Mrs. Morris and I are witnesses to that promise. All right, Governor, you've talked us into it. When do we start?
Hello? I'd like a cab, please. To go to Wentworth Detention Centre.
Oh, poor Willie. They were so close.
There won't be any publicity, so there's no reason for the women to find out.
And Willie?
She won't be coming back. Her pardon's coming through and they're arranging resettlement. Any sign of Joyce's keys?
No, not yet. Well, it won't do them any good. All the inner locks have been changed.
Yes, I've got to explain the locksmith's bill to the department.
Oh, by the way, Lou Kelly was working the press this morning.
Trouble?
Too early to say.
Keep an eye on it, mate.
Yes, I will. Now, what do you want me to do about Keane?
Did she say what she wants to talk to me about?
No.
Oh, I'll go up and see her now.
Come here.
Gotcha. Oh, sorry, should
have knocked. Oh, Mason Rubens with this one. She just can't keep her hands off me.
Well, if that is your attitude. Any sign of David yet?
No, I hope he's not too much longer. I'm supposed to be in court this afternoon. Judges are handing down a decision on Daphne's case.
Well, I've got my last lesson at Wentworth. Certainly going to be sad saying goodbye to everyone.
Yeah.
Well, did he know what time it was? Yeah, when I phoned Mum, she said she reminded him this morning. I hope he hasn't forgotten. He seems to have a lot on his mind lately.
Eve Wilder's enough to distract any man.
About it all night, and I didn't do it, you see. And
that's not what the evidence points to.
No, but look, I like Mrs. Barry, and I couldn't have hurt her like
that. Keane, we've been through all this before. You asked to see me. If you've got nothing new to add, it is simply a waste
of time. No, but there is, please. I want to ask if I can see Dr. Weissman.
Why?
Well, I've got to get someone to believe me. He listens to me, and he can tell you that I'm innocent.
There is no point in seeing Dr. Weissman.